What is up guys, and welcome back to another video. Today I am here with a great news for you guys. I recently found out a best way to play mini militia and any other Android games in your PC. So with this video I am gonna show you how to play any Android game or download any mobile apps right into your PC. Thanks to Nox App Player, it is now just a few mouse clicks away. If you don't know what Nox App Player is, in brief, I would say this is one of the best and new Android emulating software available, and it is completely free. This is the software that lets you play those mobile games in your PC. So with this software, you can try out all Android games, even if you have an iOS device or an Android device with limited features or even no smartphone at all. So without wasting much time, let's download the software right now. For that, click on the download link given in the description box below and you will be taken to this page in here. From here, click on this download button and start downloading the software. Once the software is downloaded, just install it into your computer. There is nothing you have to do for that than just a couple of clicks. You wouldn't even have to reboot your PC after the install, like any other similar softwares. And so now here you have it. This is just like a new Android device. So now without further ado, I'm gonna go to the Play Store and start downloading my favorite games. Before that, let's sign into the Play Store as you do with any new Android device. You can either sign in with a new Google account and use it as your secondary smartphone, or sign in with your existing Gmail account and continue playing all games from your last progress. And now continue with all the formalities required. Now everything is set and I'm gonna download a couple of games and show you how to play them with the software. I'm gonna go with Mini Militia, Clash of Clans, Asphalt Nitro and Bullet Force. All these games are from different categories. Also remember that you can download any other mobile apps and softwares like WhatsApp, Snapchat, Android launchers, wallpapers, etc. Also, there is inbuilt screenshot and screen recording feature in the software. And when all these games get downloaded, I'm gonna play them in my PC. And you guys, let's see how I set my controls and play these games. At first, I'm gonna go with Clash of Clans. There is no need for setting controls for this game. Just click with your mouse pointer as you touch on your mobile screens and carry on with your gameplay. Okay, now I'm gonna collect my resources. As you guys can see, I'm Town Hall 8 and maxing them. I have also uploaded a couple of Clash of Clans videos. If you haven't seen them, just go check them out in my channel. And let's see how we are doing in this war. This is awesome, right? We scored full stars again this time. I'm just seeing it now. Seems like our boys did a great job. It's like a fourth time for us scoring full stars. I know we are a level 6 clan and fourth time is not that great actually. But still, it's good, right? Anyway, we are currently recruiting and looking up for new war members. So if you are a Town Hall 8 or above, feel free to join and fight with us. Since I already have my troops trained and ready, I am going for a battle now. Actually, I am not looking for loots nowadays. My storage is almost full with elixirs and I don't have anything to upgrade with them. And now this base looks good and I'm going for it. At first, let's check out their reinforcement with just an archer. Okay, it seems empty, so I'm gonna use a couple of archers to take his builder's hut. And let's use a P.E.K.K.A. to take out his king and some wizards to back it up. And I'm gonna deploy another P.E.K.K.A. and a couple of wizards to clean up those outer buildings. So those buildings are almost cleared and made a path for our Valkyries. These Valkyries are not going as I wanted to, but still they are attacking their way onto the middle of this base. That's actually good. At least they didn't went around the base. Now all I have to do is use those healing spells to keep those Valkyries alive. We are pretty much owning this base, so this is surely a 3-star battle. You guys already would have noticed a little lag in this video. It's not about the software. It's that whenever I use any screen recorder along this software, it tends to lag a bit. So if you wanna record your gameplay while playing with this software, I would recommend the inbuilt screen recorder on this software. If you use any other recorder, it's gonna lag like this. Okay, so for in this battle, I just got a 3-star, which is as expected. And that's all for this game. Now let's go to Asphalt Nitro. Actually, it's not my favorite racing game, but it's just a small size game and it takes only a little time to download. That's why I picked this one. You can also play games like Asphalt 8, Asphalt Extreme, NFS Most Wanted, Real Racing, and such similar high-end racing games with this software. Since I'm playing this game for the first time, I just got to sign in and everything. After all those introductions, let's get to set up the controls for this game. Unlike Clash of Clans, you got to set up controls for playing it in PC. Choose a control that doesn't require tilting or shaking your device. I'm gonna go with this one. Now choose maps, cars or whatever. If you are playing any games for the first time in PC, with this software, you got to set up your computer's keyboard controls with the actual touch control. That is called keyboard mapping. So click on that keyboard mapping button on the right top corner of the app and assign each key to simulate those touch functions. I am gonna assign the keys A and D instead for tapping left and right. So that now if I press A, the car will steer left and same goes with D. And then I use the keys W for nitro and D for braking. So now it just takes these 4 keys to play this mobile racing game in the PC, as of any PC racing games. Playing a racing game has never been easier and enjoyable. So let's see how good I race. What the F did I just do? I almost had this race, guys. What have I done? I don't wanna play another race and I'm just gonna have to move to another. I just can't believe I lost the first race of this game. And anyway, I'm just moving on to another game and that will be the Bullet Force. It's a first person shooter game, which are my second favorites actually, after those open world games. And the highlight about this game is that it is an online multiplayer and we can custom host matches with anybody around the globe. That means I can even play this game with you, like mini Militia, and I will be playing. So for that, stay tuned and make sure you are subscribed. So now let's do a quick play match and let me do that keyboard mapping for this game also. I will have to drag this moving pad at first and adjust its size. Let's make it fit right in here. Now drag the aiming button to the aiming point. And now let's start assigning keys instead for those touch buttons. I am going to assign F for firing, space for jumping, C for crouching and G for throwing grenades. And Z to zoom your weapon and M to chat or send messages to your teammates. Now save those controls and watch a little gameplay. Okay, it seems like I'm not moving fast enough. So I'm gonna adjust the size of that movement pad and gonna make it much bigger. And now it seems to be working just fine. Our opponents were too hard to defeat, and I will be playing this game again and again. It's much smoother to play in PC rather than in your handsets. And as I said, I will be playing this game with you guys, and let's see if you could beat me. So stay subscribed for that. And now at last, going on to the last and my very favorite game, Militia. Let's see how we can set up controls and play Militia in PC. Well, for setting up the controls and for getting familiar with the new controls, go to the training menu from single player mode. From here, you can set your own comfortable keys with the keyboard mapping. Use the mouse tip to look around. For picking up a gun, I'm gonna input the key P in here and save it. Again, for switching your guns, I'm gonna use the key O. It need not always be P or O. You can always input keys as per your comfort. So whenever I press P, it's gonna swap my gun with another, and when I press O, it's gonna change my weapon to the secondary weapon. And for zooming in the view or zooming out, I'm gonna go with Z. Now for firing and looking around, use your mouse as said earlier. Well, I think firing with mouse will give you more accuracy than firing in with your touch screen. For throwing grenades, I'm gonna use the key G and R for reloading. Make sure to save after setting up each keys for your control. And now for moving around, drag that movement pad from the keyboard mapping menu and set it above the movement scroll pad on the screen and make it a little bit larger like this. So now with W, A, S and D, you can fly around as you want. Now set the key M for melee attack and let's beat him up. Seems like he can't even take a beating, he just flew away. So now it seems like all these controls are set and you'll be familiar with it by now. So now just play survival mode to master these controls. For me, I was able to play the game a whole lot better even at the first time on my computer. Tonight we're running on the right track. So that's it for today guys. I hope this video was very helpful for you. If it was, please smash that like button and let's see if you guys could get 200 likes for me for this video. Also, make sure to share this video with your friends. Comment below your experience with playing any of these games for the first time in PC. And thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys in my next video. Until then, peace.
You're told.